welcome you back to GEHA Field at Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. We're in quarter number two, and it's the Chiefs who are in possession of the football. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final shot before the half for Mahomes. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman.
Yeah.
And that is incomplete. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting 49ers on top. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Yeah. All right, BG, thanks very much. And welcome one and all to our beautiful new downtown Orlando studios for this EA Sports Halftime Report. This one has certainly been one-sided to this point.
Yeah,
quite a few. It's a two-touchdown difference as the teams have already come back out onto the field for the second half. So let's get you back out as well to Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always to you and the gang in Orlando as we welcome everyone back in for quarter number three. Taking in at the three. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. Debo Samuel and the 49ers back in possession here.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. That's George Karloftis greeting him behind the line with a big stop.
But sometimes that option can get bogged down before the gears really even get into motion, and I think that's what we saw there.
And I think what he saw defensive end right in his face because he looked up and he was right there. Didn't even have a chance to get going.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12. Up the gut, McCaffrey. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. Now he will have a first down here at about the 40.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've run the bell three times with passing touchdowns, but guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
This time they'll throw it. Here's Purdy. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
So now first and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 41. McCaffrey running up the middle and not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Throwing here, Purdy. And he will find his man, Samuel. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 16. A gain there of 21 yards. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Out of the pistol, McCaffrey. He will push his way down to about the 14. Brought down by Willie Gay. On second down, here's a keeper by the QB.
And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 4 yards there on the keeper, but still going to bring up a third down.
In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Purdy now to throw.
Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And the Niners are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
This offense continues to be a hot knife through butter. 3 drives, 3 scores, and knocking on the door again on drive number 4.
And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown.
Brandon Ayuk,
a 6-yard touchdown run.
And the Niners take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical. That's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Gold able to tack on the extra point. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21.
Robbie Gould to kick off for San Francisco.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. So here's the Chiefs offense ready for their first reps in half number 2. Will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Open man completes it to Smith-Schuster. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Second down, McKinnon. 7 yards there and a first down.
Second and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
On first down, McKinnon again. And good vision there as he's across midfield and down to the 45-yard line. That goes for a Chiefs first down, 14 yards.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. 3 quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Here's second and 1 yard.
Throwing now is Mahomes. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Looking to throw is Mahomes. He'll find Smith-Schuster again. And he's going to get this down near the 25. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and lead the game out that way.
Mahomes firing complete. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20.
He's already already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
It's Kelce on the ground. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10. Now a first and 10 at the 11.
That's another Kansas City Chiefs.
Mahomes taps this forward. It's a jet sweep. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7.
That's a nice job there defensively, being able to diagnose that little touch pass. They saw it coming, converged on it before he could get much out of it.
Mahomes to throw once more. A quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
The Chiefs on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Now here's Mahomes. He's got it. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. It's a 7-yard gain and good enough to move the chains.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going.
Try to run this one in, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
This is a tough situation offensively because down 3 scores, the field goal kicker is not even going to come into play here. As an offensive play caller, though, you know you have to take chances. This is a time to get creative.
Have got it back to a 2-score game here in the fourth. The fourth quarter touchdown there, back to a 2-score game, but time is not their ally.
No, it's not, partner. They still have a pulse, but it's probably a little weak right now. A lot of things have to go right in these final 2 minutes plus for them. I think they have to be thinking onside kick here, and we know how difficult those are to recover.
On for the PAT. It's up and good, and it's now 28-14. So that drive spans 13 plays, and it's capped off with a Kansas City touchdown. Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And the 49er hands team does its job. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of a anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. And some room to run now. On a nice burst there as he'll take this inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. 61 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's 49er football here as we get you reset. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. Back to the ground on first, it's McCaffrey. And he fights forward for a modest 2 yard gain, second down. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ball game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he is going to have the first down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. The Chiefs quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts, and they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. And we'll see if the defense wants to stop it as they take the knee. Yard line, second and 11. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable 3rd and 7. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And he will get him down a couple yards shy of the first down marker. A nice tackle coming up from his free safety spot. It's a gain of 5, but it'll lead to a 4th down. Well, they could just run this clock out, but here is the field goal unit on 4th down. This to make it a 3-score game late. So the victory here for San Francisco, and I think they might have something in this young rookie quarterback because he certainly looked the part.
I have to ask you a question. Are you thinking similar to what I'm thinking? These rookie quarterbacks, they come in more prepared than ever before.
Year after year, they just seem more comfortable from day one.
I think you start really young now. These quarterback coaches, they play against a better competition. They go to camps across the country. Then they play big-time games in college. So when they get to the NFL, it's not quite the same, how would you say it, pressure that they felt in years past. And these kids just go out and perform.
And keep in mind, he led them to a road victory here, even more impressive. So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at EASports.com. From Kansas City, so long, everybody.